Good morning. So today we are going to discuss on electric field lines. So we already covered what you mean by charge and what will be the force between charge and what would be the force when there is a multiple charge, that means system of charge. Then we discuss what do you mean by electric field. So all these things we already covered. Today, what we are going to discuss is electric field lines. Electric field lines. So what it means? Let's see. So electric field lines. What do you mean by electric field lines? Somebody asked you. See, electric field lines are, it's nothing but it is pictorial way of representing electric field around a charge. So that means like we know that if we kept a charge, either the positive or negative, there will be a force exist between for due to that presence of that source charge, right? So that force will be representing, and that force on a unit positive charge we express in terms of electric field, right? So that electric field we can represent is a line. Okay, so that line we will call it as electric field lines, right? So represented, you can represent in four different ways: positive, negative, positive, and negative, positive, different charges. Like, so these are the four different way of representing electric field in four different scenario. Okay, so what do you mean by electric field? Somebody is asking what do you mean by electric field lines. You can write this statement. So electric field lines are nothing but it is a pictorial way of representing electric field around charges, either positive or negative, or the combination of two charges. It's nothing but it's pictorial. So an electric field line is a curve drawn in such a way that the tangent. So see, it is like a curve only, right? And the tangent to each point the tangent will give the direction of the net field at that point. So you have to write down these two points. Okay, this is a pictorial way, and the tangent at each point will give the direction of the net field at that point. So that also you have to write down, and also this different pictorial representation of different four scenarios also you have to write down. Okay. So we already studied some properties of electric field, right? So similarly, electric field, we studied four important properties. So similarly, electric field lines also have some important properties. So that, let's see what are the different properties of electric field lines. See, the electric field line direction is outward from a positive charge and inward to a negative charge. Actually, this point is common to for both electric field and electric field lines, right? See, you see, and one more point you can see like this. Let's see, I will explain that point last point. So first point, this you are already familiar. Second point is, see, if you see here, you can see that there are different electric field lines we represented, but you can see it is never intersect each other, right? It is never intersect, so there is no crossing between the field lines. So that is another property, the second property. The field lines never intersect. So what will happen if it is intersect each other? What will happen? You see, suppose these field lines and the second field lines intersect. So at this point, if these two lines intersect, what will happen? See, the tangent will be like this, right? So at this point, there will be two directions for the electric field, which is not possible. It is not possible. So that's why we can say that the field lines never intersect each other. Right? Why? Because if it is intersect, means at the point of intersection, we will not get any unique directions. We will get multiple directions. So that's why the field lines never intersect. सेकंड पॉइंट इज, फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड लाइंस डायरेक्शन इज आउटवर्ड फ्रॉम पॉजिटिव चार्ज एंड इनवर्ड वेर नेगेटिव चार्ज, एंड सेकंड पॉइंट द फील्ड लाइंस नेवर इंटरसेक्ट ईच अदर, नेवर इंटरसेक्ट. थर्ड पॉइंट यू सी, लेंथ ऑफ द वेक्टर्स प्रोपोर्शनल टू द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द फील्ड एट ईच पॉइंट. व्हाट इट मींस, थर्ड पॉइंट, कैन यू सी दिस फिगर, कैन यू सी दिस फिगर एंड कैन यू इंटरप्रेट व्हाट इट मींस, लेंथ ऑफ द वेक्टर्स प्रोपोर्शनल टू द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द फील्ड एट ईच पॉइंट. See, if you keep a unit positive charge here, it will experience a force, and I am keeping a positive charge here, it will also experience a force, right? So which will be higher? Which will be higher? Which will be higher, Aditya? If I am keeping a positive unit positive charge here and very near to the side, let it be. This distance r and this distance r2. So I am keeping a unit positive charge here, and at the end I am checking the electric field, and I am keeping another unit positive charge here. So let it be p1 position and let it be p2. Which will be higher or which will be stronger, Aditya?
C1 and C2 അല്ലേ?
P1 and P2.
P1.
So which field will be stronger? P2.
Yes.
Why?
Yes.
Why P2?
It is directed outward.
See, what is the equation to find out the this one field? F by Q, and the definition formula, you can say 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into Q divided by R square, right? Q is the source charge. So what is R? R is the
radius.
Distance, right?
Yeah.
R is the distance. So here, which is higher? At this point P1, R is small, and at point P2, R2, right? R1 and R2. Which is smaller, R1 or R2? R1 is smaller, right? So that is coming in the denominator. So if denominator decreases, then only the electric field, the answer will E will increase, right?
Yes,
so that is the mathematical conclusion. But that is not at all required, right? See, if this is a positive charge, and if someone is placed a charge here near to the charge, then only the force will be higher, right? If you're moving away, the force will decrease, right? So it's the electric field is nothing but it is the force. So it is near to the charge, the force will be more.
Okay.
Right? It is not like if I am moving away, it is like for electric field will not increase. If I am moving away, the electric field will decrease. So that's why you can see the length of this line. You see how we represented the length of the line. See, near to the charge, we represent a long line. So if I am moving away, the line size decreases. So that means it is the meaning actually. It is a meaning, it is actually electric field lines, right? It's a vector. So the length of that vector indicates its magnitude. So that is very important when you are drawing this electric field lines. The lines which is closer to the charge, the length should be higher. So when we are moving away, the length will decrease. So that is saying, third point, the length of the vectors proportional to the strength of the field at each point. Is it clear? Fourth point, is it clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is the fifth point? The field lines are perpendicular to the surface of the charge. So if you take any surface, the field lines will be perpendicular to the surface. Fourth point. Fifth point is the field lines are more closer near to the charge. Is it right or wrong? If you see here, the closeness. What is means closeness? The space between these two field lines, right? So this is the closeness. See, when I'm moving away, the distance between two adjacent field lines increases, right? So that's mean like field lines are more closer near to the charge and less closer when moving away from the charge. So that's why we can say that very near to this charge, the field density is small. What do you mean by density? Density is nothing but the number of, see, population density means number of population per unit square kilometer, right? So unit square kilometer, how many people are, that is population density. More people, more density. Similarly, here, if there are more field lines, we can say that the field density is more. So, in which area the field density is more, Anugraha? It is near to the charge or away from the charge?
Near to the charge.
Near to the charge. So that's why we can say that very near to the charge, the field strength is more. Okay. So that is the fifth point. The field lines are more closer near to the charge and less closer away from the charge. So, if you want to write the properties of the electric field lines, first you draw this, then you can write very easily. By seeing that picture itself, you can write down all these properties. See, we covered five properties. The first property was moving away, and for negative charge it is inward. Second point, it will never intersect. And third point, the length of the electric field vector is proportional to the strength of the electric field at each point. Fourth point, the field lines are perpendicular to the surface of the charge. And fifth point, the field lines are more closer near to the charge and less closer when moving away from the charge. Sixth point, if there is a single charge, they may start or end at. What it means? If there are a single charge, that single charge may be a positive charge, right? Or may be a negative charge, right? Single charge. Okay, so first I am drawing only positive. Let's see what it means. If there is a single charge, they may start or end at infinity. So, as per the statement, so I will write first, I will draw first negative charge. What is the statement? If there is a single charge, here only single charge, that is negative charge. They may start, that means electric field E, electric field lines may start or end. So if it is negative charge, the field lines, only one negative charge is, so it is infinity. This will start from infinity, right? So if there is positive charge only, there is only positive charge. What it means? The field lines start from positive charge, right? And it will end at infinity. That's the meaning of the statement. If there is a single charge, the electric field lines may start or end at infinity. Okay, Aditya, so these properties only you told me yesterday. These are the properties of electric field lines. Okay, so the confused. You confused between the properties of electric field lines and electric field. Okay, is it clear now? Aditya.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And the last property. In a charge-free region, electric field lines can be taken to be continuous curves without any break. See, drawn like the previous figure, if you see. See, in a charge field area, free area, this is charge free. There is no charge, right? So it is charge presence here. So in the charge-free area, we can consider like it's a closed, no, it's a not a closed, it is a curved kind of representation, right? In a charge-free way, electric field lines can be taken to be continuous curve, but it is not closed. But when we consider a magnetic field, so it will be continuous, right? North, south outward, and inward, south down. You can see that. So that is a continuous, but here it is not a continuous curve, but like it is curve is continuous, but it is not a closed loop. Okay, in the case of electric field, it is a continuous curve, but it is not a closed loop. But in the case of a magnetic field, you can say inside the magnet also there is a field line. So it's a closed loop, but here it is not a closed loop, but it is a continuous curve. Where there is no charge-free region, electric field can be represented as a continuous curve without any. So the last property I already told, electrostatic field lines do not form any closed loops. Electrostatic field lines do not form any closed loop, but it is a continuous curve, but it never forms a closed loop like magnetic field. Okay. And these field lines are invented by the scientist Faraday, and he called them as lines of force. Lines of force, because it's experience a force, right? If you place some charges in the field, it will experience a force. And that's why Faraday, who invented these field lines, called that field lines as a lines of force. So what do you mean by lines of force? In the choice of today, you have to write what do you mean by what the answer for what do you mean by electric field lines and what do you mean by lines of force? The answer, both answer is same. Okay, it is nothing but it is a pictorial representation of electric field, which gives the strength and direction of electric presence, like its electric field, right? So how many properties? Eight properties we discussed, right? Direction, then never intersect, length of the vector proportional to the strength and perpendicular to the surface of the charge, and field lines density is more near to the charge and less away from the charge. Fifth property. Sixth property is if there is a single charge that can start from infinity or end at infinity. So at a charge-free region, field lines can be taken as continuous curve, but electrostatic field lines do not form any closed loops. So why it is electrostatic field, Anugraha? Why it is electrostatic field?
Because electrostatic field line starts from the positive terminal and ends at the
No, no, no,
negative
no,
terminal.
no, 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 no. I'm asking why it is electrostatic. The chapter itself is electrostatic. So what is
Because
electrostatic?
charge is at rest.
Charges?
At rest, not moving.
Charges not moving. എന്താണ് ആദ്യം പറഞ്ഞത്? ചാർജിസ്
Rest, RST.
ഓക്കെ റെസ്റ്റ് ഓക്കെ സോ ചാർജ് ഇസ് നോട്ട് മൂവിങ് സോ ദാറ്റ്സ് വൈ വി ആർ ഡീലിംഗ് വിത്ത് ഇലക്ട്രോസ്റ്റാറ്റിക് ദിസ് ചാപ്റ്റർ ഈസ് കംപ്ലീറ്റ്ലി ഡീലിംഗ് വിത്ത് സ്റ്റാറ്റിക് ചാർജ് സോ ദാറ്റ്സ് വൈ ഇലക്ട്രോസ്റ്റാറ്റിക് ഫീൽഡ് So the field lines, because of the static charge, we got an electrostatic. Okay. So now we clear what do you mean by electric field, how we can represent four different representation and eight different properties of electric field lines. That also we said. Now we just have a case study. Okay. Just have a case study to find the strength of an electric. we already know very near to the charge the strength will be more, right? So just have a case study to find the strength of electron. Okay, you see this figure. You imagine this figure in a three-dimensional way. How we can imagine? This is kind of a cone. This is actually three-dimensional. If you see a broom stick, chool eduthu nokki kazhinju kazhinjal, like it will be like, so the chool is spread cheythu kazhinju engane undava, it is like a three-dimensional, like, so you compare that with this figure. So it is a three-dimensional, it's not a two-dimensional, three-dimensional you have to visualize, you have to compare with the broomstick. ചൂലുമായിട്ട് കമ്പയർ ചെയ്ത് നോക്കുക. സോ ദൻ യു ക്യാൻ ഗെറ്റ് എ വിഷ്വലൈസേഷൻ. ഓക്കെ ഓക്കെ സോ സോ നൗ യു സി, സോ ദിസ് ഈസ് വൺ ഏരിയ ആൻഡ് ദിസ് ഈസ് അനദർ ഏരിയ ആൻഡ് ഐ കെപ്റ്റ് എ ചാർജ് ക്യൂ. ദിസ് ഈസ് സോഴ്സ് ചാർജ് ക്യൂ അറ്റ് ദ ഒറിജിൻ ഓ. ഓക്കെ So the field lines at the different points indicates the relative strength or relative density or closeness of the field lines. How much closer the field lines gives the relative strength or the strength of the field lines at those points. See, if you see this point and this point P1 and P2, okay, here this path and here this area. In both area, the number of field lines, if you see, both are same, right? The number of field lines are same in, if you draw a area here and if you draw a area here, this area, and point P1 and P2 we consider over that area, that is different thing. But this area A1 and this area A2, both are different. This A2 is higher than A1. So in the both the cases, the field lines, number of field lines passing through that area is similar. It's the same. The count is same. Okay. So that is not a measure of the field line strength. If both number of lines are same, we can't say that the field strength is similar. So for measuring the field strength, we have to see how much closer the field lines. So near to the charge, this area, these field lines are more closer. That's why the field density or the field line density, what it means, the number of field lines per unit area. So I am taking a small area here, let it be R. And here also I am taking the small unit area, let it be S. Now you see, so the number of field lines passing in unit area R is more than the unit area S. So this is a measurement of field strength. So field strength is, we can measure in such a way that the number of electric field lines passing through a unit area, that gives the strength of the electric. You should not take a bigger area. So bigger area, sometimes that field lines will be, number of field lines will be smaller, is like similar. But if you want to measure the strength of the field lines, you have to take a unit area. In that unit area, if the number of field lines are more, then we can say that field strength, the strength of the field is higher. So that's why the strength near to the field, that is at R, is more than S. Clear to all of you? How we can find out the strength of the field? So this we can take it as a case study and you can write down different points, which are the things we consider. Then conclusion, you can write down this. The number of electric field lines passing through a unit area is the strength of the electric field line. So that's why you can say that the field strength is higher closer to the charge, source charge. Okay, that is very important, source charge. Is it clear? Advil, clear, case study, ഓർമ്മയാണോ?
ഇല്ല സാർ, ഉറങ്ങുന്നില്ല.
ഓക്കെ രഞ്ജു, ഇസ് ഇറ്റ് ക്ലിയർ? രഞ്ജു, സ്റ്റിൽ യു ഹാവ് മൈക്ക് പ്രോബ്ലം. ഓക്കെ, വാട്ട് അബൌട്ട് സ്വാതി, ഇസ് ഇറ്റ് ക്ലിയർ?
Yes, sir.
Next, we will do a proof. Prove that the strength of electric field at distance r from a source charge have clear dependency on 1 by r square. So this is a proof, so that we already know that the strength of field is depends on the distance from the source charge, right? So it is specifically depends on the 1 by r square, that is, it is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the source charge and the non-proportional charge. So just we have to prove in a mathematical way. Okay, so by logic we know that it is like this only, it is depends only on the 1 by r square, but how we will prove that, let's see. In a three dimension, see, are you familiar with solid angle? What do you mean by solid angle? What do you mean by angle that you write? No, right? In a two dimensional angle, you are familiar with. See, if you line two lines and they intersect, the angle between them, right? So similarly, if you draw a circle like this, and if this is a center, and if you take an arc like this, so this arc will subtend an angle theta. This arc, angle theta, and this is arc. So we know that the two-dimensional angle theta, the plane angle is equal to arc by radius. That you are familiar, right? That you are familiar, arc by radius. So this is actually a two-dimensional representation. So we will call it this angle as a plane angle. So in a three-dimension, this angle is not plane angle. So we will call it as a solid angle. So what is that actually? What do you mean by solid angle? What do you mean by solid angle? You see this figure. It is a half sphere, right? So I just cut the sphere from the center. So it is half sphere, right? So you can see this. A cone I represented, right? We can take a cone, right? From the top, if you drill down towards the center, from the top, you cut here and if you drill down to the center, you can make a cone like this, right? So this cone, just you imagine how it will look. If it is a sphere, if it is a sphere kind of thing, and I am cutting a circle in the top of the sphere and I am drilling down, so it is not like, it will subtend an angle at the center, oh, but it is not the same angle as plane angle, right? It is something different, and that angle, if you do like this, the angle subtended at the center O, we will call it as solid angle, because it is a three-dimensional, it is having x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, right? X, y and z-axis. It is a three-dimensional object, and if you do this, this is the cone, and the cone will have an angle subtended at the center O here, and that angle is known as the solid angle. So what do you mean by solid angle? Is it clear, Aditya?
Yes, sir.
Fatima?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Renju? Your voice is not coming out. is some problem in your mic or in your laptop. From the starting of the class, I'm saying this. So solid angle should be clear, otherwise the coming derivation you will not able to understand. Okay, so we know that plane angle theta is equal to arc by radius, right? So similarly, this solid angle will represent using this symbol. Since it is a very small solid angle, we are just representing delta. Delta means very small, and normally this ohm symbol, right, that will be used to represent the solid angle. So that will be equal to the delta S. Delta S means this area, top area, right? Pi r square, circular area, divided by square of the radius. Plane angle, it was nothing but theta is equal to arc by radius. Here arc, instead of arc, we have a three-dimensional property, that is the area. Because this area, this arc is not subtended. Instead of arc, it is area is subtended at the center. So we'll take this area, a small area as delta S, and r square, this distance or the radius of the sphere. So this is, you have to remember, like plane angle, solid angle is the area subtended divided by the square of the radius, delta S by r square. Okay. Now you take the same case study that we discussed in just previous slide. Okay. So now see how we can prove that. Here what we are doing. So here we are taking two different planes. Like see, this is plane 1 and plane 2. And this is the origin where we kept the source charge Q. So we need to find out the strength of the electric field at point P1 and the strength of the electric field at point P2. So how we can find out? The case study we found that, right? So say, tell me how we can find out the field strength at this point P1 and at this point P2. How we can find out? So electric field length, field strength is nothing but it is the number of field lines that is passing the unit area. So I have to consider a unit area here around this point P1. Similarly, I have to find or consider a unit area surrounding this P. So then I have to find out the number of electric field lines passing through that unit area. So that will give the strength of the electric field at this point, right? So that we have to find out number of field lines that is passing through this unit area at each point P1 and P2. We have to find out, that will give the field strength. Then that relationship, you have to prove that it depends only on 1 by r. Let's see how we will do that. At the point P1, at a distance R1, so this distance OP1 is R1, the area element that's subtending the solid angle. See, so this is an area element, and this is another area element, right? You see, the angle subtended by both the area element is same, right? For this case, this angle. So that we have taken as delta O. Okay? Oh, okay. So delta O is delta S by R square. So at the point P1, at a distance R1, the area element that subtending the solid angle delta O, how we can find out? So this area element is subtending the angle delta O, right? So how we can find out this area element if delta O is the solid angle? Then how we can find out this area? This area is similar to delta S, right? So how we can find out that area? What will be the equation from here? If solid angle is delta, what will be the equation, Aditya? To find out this area.
Sigma ohm is equal to sigma S by R.
What?
Sigma ohm is equal to sigma S by R square.
Sigma ohm. അതൊന്നും ഞാൻ പറഞ്ഞില്ലല്ലോ ഇവിടെ.
സോളിഡ് ആംഗിൾ ഇതല്ലേ പറയണ്ടേ?
ആ ഞാൻ ഇപ്പൊ ചോദിച്ചേക്കണ എന്താ ഏരിയ ആണ്. ഹൗ വി കൻ ഫൈൻഡ് ഔട്ട് ദിസ് ഏരിയ ഫ്രം ദിസ് ഇക്വേഷൻ. വി നോ സി വി നോ ദാറ്റ് ദിസ് ഡെൽറ്റ ഓം ഈസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു ഡെൽറ്റ എസ് ബൈ ആർ സ്ക്വയർ, റൈറ്റ്? സോളിഡ് ആംഗിൾ ഈസ് ഈക്വൽ ടു ദ ഏരിയ സബ്സ്റ്റെൻഡഡ് ഡിവൈഡ് ബൈ ദ ഡിസ്റ്റൻസ് ഫ്രം ദ ഒറിജിൻ ടു ദാറ്റ് പോയിന്റ്, റൈറ്റ്? So I need to find out delta S. So here delta S is the area of this portion. So how we can find out the area of this portion from this equation? Delta S is equal to delta ohm into R square, right?
Yes, sir.
So here delta ohm is same. R square is R1 square. Right? So that area, this area is equal to R1 square. Into delta. So give it as equation 1. So similarly, you find out this area. How we can find out? Because the solid angle is same, delta ohm itself.
Which
but the distance.
Which part could you show?
But what?
Random the which part I wanted to
Random the this area.
Ah.
So how we can find out that area? Same way, this equation R2 square into delta 1, because only difference is in the distance R2, right? So R2 square into delta 1. Since this is coming actually from based on this basic equation of solid angle, okay? So based on the solid angle equation, you are finding out delta S. So here delta S1 and here delta S2. You can take like that. So equation 1 and equation 2 we got, right? So now you see that the number of field lines cutting these area elements, this area elements and this area elements, the number of field lines are same, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Here also 9. So let it be taken as n. Here it is 9. So generally I am going to take the number of field lines is n, small n, cutting these area. Okay. So both are same. Okay. So this is the area element we found based on the equation 1, R1 square delta ohm is this area element, and R2 square delta ohm is this area. And we got the number of field lines passing. This area element is also n and this area element is also n small. So what we need to find out now? We need to find out the strength of the electric. The strength of the electric field, it is nothing but number of field lines passing unit area. Number of field lines passing through unit area. So now we know the number of field lines passing through R1 square delta ohm. R1 square delta ohm is n. Similarly, R2 square delta ohm for this area. So the number of field lines passing through the area at R2 square delta ohm is also n. So how we can find out the number of field lines passing unit area? Consider only this area. So what is the area? R1 square delta ohm, right? So number of field lines passing through R1 square delta ohm. That is the first area where the P1 stands for. Is how many number of electric field lines? N. Then the number of field lines passing through the unit area. Unit area means always 1, right? Unit area means always 1. So let it be 1. Unit stands for 1. So 1 meter square. The number of field lines that is passing through unit area. number of field lines passing through this total area we know, that is R1 square. So this area will have this number of field lines. Then how many number of field lines will pass through unit area? How we can find out? Tell me, Advil.
Sir.
How we can find out? Mango story auto ekanamna. So many times I'm telling 10 mango, 10 rupees. One mango, how you will find? Save
it.
Mango story ana parayunde.
Alla 10 mango 10 enda irna parne.
10 mango 10 rupees. One mango, how many rupees?
1 rupees.
Engane kitti?
Divided by 1. Divided by.
Same way, kandupidikkudu. 10 mango is equal to 10 rupees. So here mango left side, right side rupees. 10 mango, 10 rupees. So 1 mango, how are you finding 1 into 10, right?
Yes.
Divided by 10.
1 10 by 10.
Correct or not? 1 into 10 divided by 10, right? That is 1 rupee. Same way do this. This area, the left side I am writing area, right side I am writing number of field lines.
R delta,
no, 1 into n divided by, you have to start from 1 into n divided by R1 square delta. അങ്ങനെയല്ലേ ചെയ്തേ, വൺ ഇൻറ്റു ടെൻ ഡിവൈഡ് ബൈ ടെൻ, റൈറ്റ്? ടെൻ ബൈ ടെൻ. സിമിലർലി ഹിയർ വൺ ഇൻറ്റു എൻ ഡിവൈഡ് ബൈ ആർ വൺ സ്ക്വയർ ഡെൽറ്റ. സോ ദിസ് ഈസ് വെരി ബേസിക് മാംഗോ സ്റ്റോറി. യു ഹാവ് ടു റിമെമ്പർ ദിസ്. യു ക്യാൻ അപ്ലൈ ഇൻ ഓൾ ദ ഡെറിവേഷൻസ്. ഓക്കെ, സോ സിമിലർലി സീ ദ ലോജിക് യു ഹാവ് ടു അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ്. So what we are finding? We are finding electric field. Electric field is nothing but the number of field lines per unit area. So here what we are finding? The number of field lines that is passing through this total area is, you know, that is n we are taken. Then if you want to find out for unit area, that is n divided by R1 square into delta. So how this comes, that is you have to compare with the magnitude. Okay? So that will be always smaller, right? So if this area having n number of field lines, this unit area will have less number of field lines, right? Compared to this, it is 9 number of field lines here in this example. Here this unit area will have only 3 to 4, so it is lesser, right? So that we will get by dividing the total field lines by the area, total area, we will get the number of field lines passing through. Clear? So similarly, if it is given equation 3, for this case also, you can find out the number of field lines cutting unit area. Because here also the total number of field lines is n. So n divided by the total area. What is this area here, Aditya? What is this area?
Sir, could you show that, sir, for me?
This area.
I can't see.
Where P2 stands?
P2, that is R2.
Not P2, this is this area. What is this area?
You are
already breaking?
Now it's not breaking. Now can you take?
So, I found the area here, right?
Yes, sir.
R1 square delta ohm. That I found. What is this area? We already derived. What is this area?
R2 square sigma.
Delta sigma. Delta ohm, right? So that is a solid angle. So solid angle into the radius will give the radius square will give the area subtended by this portion. It's a 3 dimension. Okay. So that area we got. So this area will have n number of electrons. So if I'm taking a small unit area over that, that will give n divided by r2 square delta o. That is equation 4. So you compare equation 3 and equation 4. Here n is a constant. N is a constant. And delta ohm is also a constant, right? Here also n is a constant. This delta ohm is also a constant, right? In the both the cases, number of field lines is n, right? Passing through this total area is n. And the solid angle subtended by the both area element, this area element, this area element is also same, right? That is delta ohm. But only the variable is r1 square and r2 square. That is 1 by r1 square and 1 by r2. So, from this equation 3 and 4, we can say that the strength of the electric field depends on 1 by r. Strength of electric field lines depends on 1 by r square. Clear? Any doubts? Here you have to understand first what do you mean by solid angle. Okay? Then, from that solid angle, we are finding out this area. So that is very important concept. This equation, plane angle equation, you already know. Similarly, you have to remember this equation for solid angle also. Understand what you mean by solid angle, okay? And remember this solid angle. So we have to find out the electric field at a distance. So electric field is nothing but it is the number of field lines passing through unit area. That is also a strength of an electric field, right? So that you need to find out. If you want to find out that, first you have to know the number of field lines passing through the total area. That is already given, it is n. So here also it is n. So based on that, we have to find out the field lines passing through unit area. Question 3 gives the number of field lines passing through unit area of this first area element. And equation 4 gives the number of field lines passing through this second area. So by both the equation n and delta ohm is constant, so it is directly depends on 1. Clear? Anugraha? Fatima?
Yes, sir.
Clear, right? Any doubts, Fatima?
No, sir.
No. Okay. So we will move. So now we study what you mean by electric field lines. Then one case properties of let's 7-8 properties of electric field lines. Then one case study and one proof. That is, it depends only on 1 by r. Field length, field strength. Okay, depends on 1 by r. So now we electric charge we discuss. Then electric field we discuss. Then electric field lines we discuss. Charge, electric charge gives electric field, then electric field will represent electric field lines, and electric field lines strength also we measured. Now we come to electric flux. Electric flux is nothing but the number of field lines that is passing through a particular area. That is before going to electric flux, just you have to recollect the topic that you study already. Like, what do you mean by vector and scalar? Then, what do you mean by x and y component of a vector? And what do you mean by area vector and its direction? Area, is it a vector or a scalar? Area is a vector or a scalar. So normally we will consider area as a scalar only, right? It is don't have any direction, right? But in physics, we will consider area as a vector. Why should we treat an area element as a vector? Why should we treat an area? What is an area element? See. So this is an area element, right? This is a area element, rectangular. So this is an area element. So this area element is considered as a vector in physics. Why? This is because the amount of element, so the amount of flow through that area element. So if something is flowing through this area, let it be water. So I am connecting a pipe here and water is flowing through this. Let it be. Okay, water is. So, amount of flow of water through this area element depends on the direction of the area element, right? Suppose instead of this, I am keeping this area element like this. So, water will flow like this. Here also water will flow. Here the total water is flowing through this entire area. This area will comes the total water, let it be the volume V. The total water is flowing off through this area. But in this case, you see, I just place this area element like this, slightly with an angle. Now some water will flow without touching this area element and some amount of water will flow this through this area. Right? So the direction of this area element having some importance, right? How we keep this area element. That is also. So that's why we take care this area element as a vector. Okay. So instead of water, you just compare the electric field lines passing through this area element. Just we imagine. So that will also will depend the direction of this area element, right? The direction of this area. If I'm keeping like this, more number of areas. If I'm keeping in like this, the number of field lines passing through that area element will change, right? It will reduce, right? So that's why this area element, direction of the area element is very important when you study electric field lines. Okay? And the normal, so this is an area element, okay? And the normal to this plane, that is n, the vector n, is represent the area vector direction. So the normal to the plane specifies the orientation of the plane, right? So if I am tilting this, this normal will also will tilt, right? If I am changing the direction of this area element, this normal will also will change, right? This n will be like this here. So this normal will give the direction of the area. Okay. So that is very important. So area is a vector we considering. Why this? Get from here. Because it is very important. And the direction of the area element is given by the normal to that area. So now there is a confusion, right? There are different kinds of area elements. Sometimes we will have a plane, two-dimensional area element. Like if you take a cardboard like this, only it's two-dimensional, x and y direction. Two-dimensional curve. But if you take a sphere or any three-dimensional, let it be, this is a three-dimensional, it looks like a mango, right? So it is a kind of three-dimensional, right? So in the two-dimensional case, the normal, it will be like this, upward or it will be downward. Both direction is possible in the case of two-dimensional. But when we come to a three-dimensional, see most of the cases, the field, like when we study the electric, yes. Okay, you can leave. The most of the cases, the electric field line when you study, that will be moving like, that will be passing through a three-dimensional. Okay, so this second case is a three-dimensional. But in the three-dimensional case, the normal, so the direction of this area element, here it is the area element is delta s. So that area element is always taken as outward to the surface. That is very important. Two dimensional, we can take either outward or downward. It's not a problem. But when we come to a three dimensional, the second figure, the direction of the normal or the area vector is always outward to the surface. Very, very important. Very, very important. outward to the sun. This is the convention that we are seeing. Okay? So, what do you mean by area vector? In two dimension, it will be outward or inward. So, that normal to the area will give the direction of the area vector. In two dimension, it will be outward or downward. But in three dimension, always we will take the direction of these. Area element is outward. That is right. And so area vector, hope it is clear. Okay, in two dimensional case also, three dimensional case. Now we will discuss what is electric flux. So electric flux definition we already discussed yesterday, right? So we compared with water flow. And if certain amount of water is flowing across section in a particular time, we can say the rate of flow of water, right? So in 1 second, if 1 cubic meter of water is flowing through a cross section of a pipe, then it's the rate of flow of water. We can say that. Similarly, the total number of electric field lines, total number of electric field lines like this. Total number of electric field lines passing through a given area. Let it be this area. Total number of electric field lines that is passing through this given area in unit time. That is 1 second. Or the rate of flow of electric field lines through a cross section, through an area, vertical area is defined as that. So it's nothing but it's giving something related to the speed of flow. Okay, rate of flow. Okay. So once again, the total number of electric field lines passing a given area in unit time is defined as the electric flux. Clear to all of you? Any doubt? Any doubt? Is it clear?
No, sir.
Okay. It is the rate of flow of electric field. So it is actually depends on the number of electric field lines depends upon the like what? Or the rate of flow of electric field lines depends on the strength or how many electric field and the size of that area. So if delta S is the size of the area and E is the electric field. So electric flux delta phi is the product of electric field and delta S. Since electric flux is a scalar, we will take it as a scalar product or dot product. Or if the resultant, if suppose electric flux is a, what you call, like if it is a vector, normally we will take it as vector product or cross product. Since here, electric flux is a scalar quantity, we will take it as cross product. E dot delta S is equal to cross thing. Let's see why this is taken. It is dot product instead of cross product. Why we took dot product? Let's see. And the unit of electric flux is from this equation. So delta S is the area, that is area unit is meter square. A unit of electric field is E is equal to F by Q. So, Newton per Coulomb. So, combine both, we will get the electric flux unit as Newton Coulomb. Newton per Coulomb meter square. Newton per Coulomb meter square. Okay. So, the delta S is the small area element of the big area. Okay. You see this. So, we will take three different scenarios. How the electric flux intensity or how the electric flux varies. First case, see here all the electric field lines, the red lines are electric field lines. Now you see this is the area, this is an area and this perpendicular is showing what? What is this perpendicular N? What is this perpendicular N? What is this perpendicular? Yes, it is the area vector. So this perpendicular will give the direction of this area, right? So area vector is always perpendicular to the given area. So that this n is the area vector. Now you see, this is like this electric field and area vector is like this. So if we keep horizontal or parallel, if the area element is parallel to the electric field lines, you see no electric field lines are passing through the area element. So the electric flux for this particular situation will be zero or maximum. Zero or maximum, it will be zero. Now you apply the formula. See, what is the formula? E dot delta S. E dot delta S is E delta S cos theta, where theta is the angle between the electric field and the area vector. Area vector. So this area vector is, so what is the angle between electric field and area vector here, Aditya? What is the angle between electric field and area vector in this case one?
Sir, could you repeat the question?
What is the angle between this electric field and the area vector for this case?
90 degrees,
right? So you substitute theta is 90 degrees, so E delta S cos 90 is 0. So this is the minimum electric flux. If the area element is parallel to the area element is parallel to the electric field, but the area element vector or the area vector is perpendicular, so the area element direction we will specify using the this vector only. So when the electric field is perpendicular or the area vector, if it is perpendicular to the electric field lines, theta will be 90 degrees, so we will get the minimum. So in the case 3, you see the case 3. In this case, you see this area vector, this is the area element, but area vector is this perpendicular to the area element. So here you see the area element or the area vector is parallel to the electric field lines. The theta, that is angle between the normal or the area vector and the electric field, is 0. Cos 0 is 1, since theta is 0, cos 0 is 1. So we will get E into delta F. So here, this will be the maximum electric flux situation. If you keep this area element like this, that means area element is perpendicular to the electric field, but this area element vector is parallel to the electric field. So you will get the maximum electric flux. Electric flux is nothing but it is the rate of flow of electric field or electric field lines passing through this area element in unit time. This is case 3, you will get the maximum. Here you will get the minimum. You can see that from the figure itself, you can see that it is minimum, right? This horizontally we kept the area element. Here it is perpendicular kept the area element. So this will give the maximum electric flux and this will give the minimum electric flux. Okay. But don't, you should be very careful that this area vector is perpendicular to the area element. So we are, the theta is not between the, theta is the angle between this normal and the electric flux. Don't confuse that it is the angle between the area element and the electric flux. That is true. Theta is the angle between the area vector and the vector. So case 1 and case 3. Case 1 is the minimum and case 3 is the maximum. Now this, you see, this is an intermediate. Here clearly the normal or the area vector, this is the area and this is the area vector. makes an angle theta with the electric field line. So here it would be intermediate. This will not be minimum, not maximum. This case 2 will be an intermediate. So you substitute the exact angle theta, you will get the value of electric flux E into delta S cos theta. Clear? So what do you mean by, from this slide, you should understand what is the definition, what is the formula, and what is the minimum and maximum electric flux situation and intermediate situation. Clear? Can I move to the next slide? Any doubts? On this left, yes.
Could you tell the third one? I didn't get
this one.
Third one.
Okay. So this case, you see in the first case, you kept the area element parallel. Area element is parallel to the electric field, but the area element vector is perpendicular. So theta is 90 degrees. So cos 90 is 0. So this will be 0. That will be the flux, electric flux is 0 in this case. But here, the theta, that is the angle between this area element vector and electric field is 0, right? This angle is 0, both are parallel. Electric field vector and area vector both are parallel. Thus, theta will be 0. So, cos 0 is 1. So, this we will get the maximum, right? Because cos value, the value of cos is maximum is 1. So, we are getting the maximum here, 1, right? Cos theta, cos 0 is 1. So, we get V into delta S. So, this case is the maximum. Clear?
Aye.
Okay. So, to see, now we took a very small area element. So, here we are taking this delta S is a very small portion of this big area element. Okay? Very small portion. So, now we have to take, if you so that's why we took the delta phi. Delta phi. So that's an electric flux through delta x. Delta is very small element. And delta phi is the very small electric flux that is proportional to the delta s. So to calculate the total flux through any given space surface. So that if you want to calculate the total flux for that particular total area A, so we have to divide the big surface, the big area element into small area elements, and that small area elements is delta S, and calculate the flux of each area element and add them F. So the total flux will be equal to summation of E dot delta S. Okay? E dot delta S. The summation, if you then the delta phi, you will get total phi. The summation delta phi 1, delta phi 2, etc. delta phi 1 will be equal to the total delta. The summation of E into delta. Now, electric field is E is taken to be constant over the small area element. So, since we divided this total area, big area element into small pieces, the electric field in each element will not be much different. Small will be same. So, E will be taken as constant. So, now we can make the delta S is very small. We can take it as delta S turn to 0. And we can apply an integration. We can apply limit to this equation. Limit delta S turns to 0. Then we can apply, after applying limit, we can convert this equation in the integral form of delta based on delta S. Delta S. So we can apply integration also to find out the total flux over the big area. This area.